last presenter, Dr. Neaz Mahmoud Haider, Assistant Professor, Bangladesh Institute of Ultrasound in Medicine and Research. His topic is ultrasound diagnosis of fetal heart anomaly.
My presentation today is ultrasound diagnosis of fetal heart anomaly. I feel and believe that if we know the normal anatomy looks like, then we can easily diagnose the abnormalities. So my aim today is first to go some brief description of fetal heart in several cardiac views, and then the checklist to do the fetal cardiac echocardiography, and then we will go some anomalies. Complete assessment of fetal cardiac anatomy requires different views necessary to evaluate the central connections from the mano-arterial junction to the ventricular arterial one, and the ductal and aortic arches. Only by obtaining these views, it is possible to confirm a normal sequential anatomy. And these are the several views in transverse section adopted by AIUM. This is the four chamber view. This is the section plane, and this is the four chamber view, and this is the LVOT view, and this is the section view, and this is the right ventricular arterial tract view, and this is the abyss superior to previous one, and lastly in transverse section this is the three vessel view. These are the longitudinal section, this is the bicarbon view, and this is the section, and this is the aortic arch view, and in aortic arch view we get the head and neck vessels, and this is the ductal arch view, and the difference is that here there is no branching, and this is the four chamber view. This is the short axis view of great arteries, and this is the short axis view of ventricles. So before going to fetal echocardiography, we have to define or locate the fetal heart in which side, in normal fetus. We know that the fetal stomach is in the left side, and also the fetal heart is on the left side. So define the localization and abdominal situs. The presentation of the fetus may be capillary, bridge or transverse. The spine is upward towards the transducer, maybe backwards or maybe lateral. Confirm that both the stomach and the heart are on the left side. This is our everyday practice. We do the abdominal circumference, and in the abdominal circumference, this is the stomach, which indicates that it is the fetal left side, and this is the descending aorta, which is a bit left to the midline. And this is the IVC in the right side and liver in the right side. So from this section, we go to the cranially of the fetus, and just above the diaphragm, we will find the four chamber view. The right hand rule of thumb for the transabdominal scanning is used to locate the heart in which side. This is the palm, which represents the fetal abdomen. The dorsum of the hand represents the fetal back, and the fist represents the fetal head, and the direction of the thumb represents the left side of the fetus. And as I mentioned earlier, the fetus may be in the capillary, may be in the bridge, the fetus may be in the supine, or may be in the prone position. So in that, if the fetus is in cephalic position with back up, then we will found the stomach in this section, in the left side. this is the left side and this is the right side. And in that case, we will found the heart and the apex of the position of the apex is here. Here the fetus in cephalic and his abdomen is in anterior, and this is the here we will get the stomach. This is the indicate in the left side. So we finally proceed the probe towards the fetal head. We will get the fetal heart in this position. If the fetus is in this position and back is up, then we will found this type of abdominal subcompense, and the stomach indicates it is the left side of the fetus, and the position on of the heart is here, and the apex is here in this position. If the fetus is in this presentation and the fetus is in supine or the back is down, then we will get the stomach here, and this indicates it is the left side, and the heart apex of the heart is on the left side, and we will get this type of picture. So from our abdominal circumference, we'll this is the fetal lie long in long axis, and if we proceed to the fetal head, we'll get the fetal four chamber view. This is the four chamber view, and this is the right ventricle, which is the most anterior chamber, and to locate the fetal heart, this is the descending aorta, which is just close to the spine. So this is the descending aorta, and from this side is the left side, left atrium, left ventricle, right ventricle, which also contains the moderator valve, and this is the right atrium. This is the foramen ovale, and this is the normal anatomy, and both the ventricles are of equal size, and both the atrium are also are of equal size. And this is the four chamber view, how we'll get the four chamber view in detail. And this is the four chamber view. As I mentioned, this is the descending aorta, this is the spine, and this is the right ventricle, most anterior chamber. And here, the right ventricle contains the moderator band, and by which we can identify this is the right ventricle. And this is the interventricular septum. These are the antiventricular valves, and this is the flap of the foramen ovale, which opens into the left atrium. This is the left ventricular outflow tract view. And in this view, we all get all the structure as I shown you in the four chamber view, except the right atrium. And here we will get the origin of the ascending aorta from the left ventricle. Here also all the structure like descending aorta, left ventricle, left atrium, left ventricle, and right ventricle is present. This is the ultrasound scan. This is the left ventricular outflow tract view. This is the four chamber view. This is the interventricular septum, and this is the descending aorta. This is the diaventricular outflow tract view. This is the pulmonary artery with its branches. Right ventricle and pulmonary artery with branches and aorta in cross section. And this is the right ventricle, right atrium, and pulmonary artery with its branches, the aorta at the center. And this is the three vessels from the right ventricular outflow tract view. If we go further superior to the fetal head, we will find the three vessel view, three vessel trachea view. And in this view, the pulmonary artery and the aorta are of equal size, not in a normal fetus. This is the three vessel view, and this is the longitudinal view. or aortic arch. From the left ventricular view, if we rotate the transducer, then we will get the aortic arch view, and the differentiating point is that it contains the headed neck vessels. These are the vessels, and the vessels are subclavian artery, left subclavian, left carotid, and the ventricle of the pulmonic arteries. And this is the ductal view. The ductal arch view, it originates from the right ventricle, pulmonary bulk, and the ductus arteriosus, and ductus arteriosus then opens but unites with the aorta. Here, the ductus arteriosus, and which unites with the ductus aorta, the descending aorta. This is the longitudinal view of the bicuspid view. Both the vena cava opens into the right atrium. This is the bicuspid view. Now, before going to specific cardiac anomalies, we have some checklist, and these are the we know that the heart occupies one third of the chest, and the other two thirds occupied by two lungs, and the heart itself occupies two thirds of the left chest, two thirds of the left side, and the apex is in the left side. This is the two pulmonary veins opens into the right atrium, and the both the atrium are of equal size. This is the right atrium, and this is the left atrium. The flap of the left atrium normally opens into the left atrium, and the tubes or the center of the heart, we should look whether it is present or not. And both the ventricles are of equal size, and the walls of the ventricles are both symmetric, and we also look the contractility of the heart. And then we'll look for the intact ventricular septum. Now, what we can assess or find the abnormalities in four chamber view. If the four chamber view is normal, we can exclude 60% of cardiac anomalies, congenital cardiac anomalies. And this is the normal four chamber view. Here, this is the right atrium is hugely enlarged, and this is due to the tricuspid atresia, tricuspid insufficiency. And here, this is the right atrium is enlarged, and the AV valves, the leaflet of the AV valves is abnormally inserted into apically, and it is the Egestin anomaly. Here, this is the ventricular septal defect. The ventricular septum is not intact, here is the defect. This is the atrioventricular septal defect, and there is a common atrium. Here, the left heart is small. The left heart is small, hypoplasia of the left heart, or hypoplastic left heart syndrome. And here, this is the opposite, and the left ventricle, left atrium, left ventricle, left atrium, the right heart is hypoplastic, right ventricular hypoplasia. And here, we found the common atrium. Here, this is the common ventricle, or the single ventricle. Both two ventricle, two atrium opens, the atrioventricular valve opens into the single ventricle. Here, there is the disproportion of ventricle. The left ventricle is small and the right ventricle is enlarged. And this is an indirect sign of coagulation of aorta. and here and the biventricular hypertrophy, and here there is a mass in the fetal heart, and Bhujamustan in the morning shows we can get some echogenic foci in the fetal heart, and which indicates abnormality. These are the this is the common axiom, atrioventricular septal defect, and this is the wide foramen oval, and this is the wide foramen oval septal defect, secundum meriti. And this is again the enlarged right atrium with leaflets, posterior leaflets, and the septal leaflets abnormally inserts apically, and this is the Eveystein anomaly, and here this is the ventricular septal defect. This is also some ventricular septal defect, double, and this is the single ventricular septal defect. This is the common axiom, and with double inlet, both the ventricles open into a single atrium. And this is the left ventricular hypoplastic syndrome. When left ventricle is extremely hypoplastic, and the right ventricle is normal. And here the left ventricle is normal, and the right ventricle is hypoplastic, and a small interventricular septal defect also noted here. This is the single ventricle and single atrium. Single ventricle with single atrium and a single atrioventricular valve. This is a single ventricle with double atrium. And this is the, again, the one of the left ventricular hypoplasia, left heart hypoplasia. Hypoplastic left heart syndrome. This is the right ventricle is enlarged in comparison to the left gland, left ventricle, and it is the indication of coagulation of aorta. Now, what we can found in the left ventricular outflow tract view, and this is the normal left ventricle originates from the ascending aorta originates from the left ventricle, and this is the intact interventricular septum. And this is the normal left ventricular outflow tract view, and this is in the during the systole, the mitral valve is closed and the aortic valve is open. But in during diastole, the mitral valve is open and the aortic valve is closed. And these are the anomalies of the outflow tract, critical stenosis of aorta. And here, this is the left ventricular outflow tract view, and the aorta is small in size. And here, without stenosis is present, but the without gross anomalies of the left ventricle. Here, the stenosis is present, but there is enlargement of the left ventricle, which is known as the fibroelastosis, endocardial fibroelastosis. These are the anomalies of the crossover, and this is the right ventricle, and from right ventricle, both the great arteries originate. And here, the position of the great arteries, the aorta originates from the right ventricle, and the pulmonary artery originates from the left ventricle. This is the anomalies of the septal aortic continuity. Here, the septal outlet, BHD, and the septum is normally aligned. with the anterior aortic wall. But here, the septum is malalignment and the aorta overrides the defect. This is the malalignment gauge disc, and the previous one, and the septa, the aorta overrides the defects. And this is the outlet GHD consisting of a simple defect of the outflow perimembranous part of the septum. And this is the transposition of the great arteries. Aorta originates from the right ventricle and the pulmonary artery originates from the left ventricle. This is again the both the great arteries originates from the right ventricle, and here the aortic, critical aortic stenosis with marked fibrillar stasis of the left ventricle. This is a normal RVOT, and here in systole the tricuspid valve is closed and the pulmonary artery, the pulmonary valve is open. But in case of diastole, the tricuspid valve is open and the pulmonary artery is closed. And this is the right ventricular artery tube, right ventricle pulmonary artery, right ventricle pulmonary artery with branches. And this is the right ventricular artery tract anomaly. The right ventricle, both the left and right pulmonary branches are enlarged. And this is the pathology of Fallot. This is a ventricular septal defect inlet variety, and this is the perimembranous VHD. This is the muscular VHD, and these are the VHD. When we put color, we can assess, we can found the flow through the defects. These are the atrioventricular septal defects, and this is the alignment of the valves, and this is the atrioventricular septal defect, and this is the pulmonary artery aorta, small aorta. This is the atrioventricular septal defect, and this is the partial atrioventricular septal defect. So, fetal echocardiography is a part of routine evaluation of non-fetus. The prenatal diagnosis of congenital heart disease depends on the knowledge, skill, and experiences of the sonologist. Therefore, we should be completely familiar with basic fetal echocardiography. Thank you all, and this is Jumma Mubarak, and the best time of the Jumma Mubarak is the prayer time, is the after asr. Allah Ta'ala accept the prayer in this time. Thank you all.
Thank you, sir, for your nice and valuable presentation. Now, I would like to request Mr. Arifur Islam, the service engineer from Transmit Limited, for his presentation on file.